so it's chapter five, and it's called Neoliberal Democracy versus Neoliberal Authoritarianism. And I subtitle it Capitalism and Democracy's Global Contest in the 21st Century. And I use that to sort of engage, you know, the question that you're asking, and engage, you know, the handbook's, you know, key themes around democracy and development. You know, at least three questions that the book uses to unravel these linkages between democracy and development are as follows. Do democratic regimes offer better prospects for development than authoritarian regimes? And a second question would be, should the achievement of socioeconomic development be prioritized by countries with the understanding that this will provide much more favorable conditions for democratization? So those are key questions that the book asks, and I apply those questions to more specificity around questions of neoliberalism. So my chapter applies these questions to contemporary political and economic processes of global development, captured especially by what I call the paradigmatic shifts that neoliberalism had on the global political economy in the 21st century. And so to examine the relationship between democracy and development around the world, I'm interested in showing how neoliberalism has shaped the state of contemporary democracy and development in the US, in Europe, in Africa, in Asia, and in Latin America. And my chapter draws case study examples from all five regions. Theoretically, I use Nicholas Olson's concept of neoliberal democracy, defined as a sort of laissez-faire economy that deepens, he claims, democracy by expanding freedoms to the consumer. But I also counterpoise that concept with a scholar called Ian Brough, and his concept is authoritarian neoliberalism. And he counters, you know, Olson's thesis about neoliberal democracy, claiming that actually neoliberalism, it's a political economic process that undermines liberal democracy because it restructures the state into a less democratic entity that seeks to suppress social and democratic movements. So in using that as a theoretical framework, you know, I pose some questions of my own to explore the relationship between democracy and development in the 21st century. I ask, how do neoliberal democracy and authoritarian neoliberalism help us to understand the relationships between democracy and development and capitalism? I ask, does neoliberalism lead to authoritarianism? A huge question. So what is the outcome of neoliberalism's political economic transformation on democracy around the world? That's sort of my thesis, my research question. How do I sort of end up finding around that? Well, this chapter gives you some answers. I claim that neoliberalism has actually undermined democratization all around the world, the advanced industrial world, the developing world, and it's done so by increasingly destabilizing liberal democracy, and especially undermining liberal democracy in the West. But in the developing world, it's deconsolidating or sort of reversing substantive consolidation of democracy in the global South. So there is this grand contradiction that my chapter tries to tease out. I claim that the crisis of neoliberalism, even post-financial crisis of 2008, will still not lead to a post-neoliberalism, but as a matter of fact, it's leading to what we call an authoritarian neoliberalism and the demise of democracy. I think the most poignant example is my rendition of the contemporary politics of the United States but I also used the UK to examine the transformations of neoliberalism from Thatcher to Boris Johnson to say the same thing. And, you know, I go around the world. I go to Africa, to Latin America, to Asia to explore concepts of choiceless democracy, authoritarian democracy, delegative regimes, to show how neoliberalism is, you know, really sort of undermining democracy and development around the world.